Normally, clean rain is slightly acidic with a pH of about 6 because of the presence of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. But the precipitation, the rain with a pH less than 5 is known as acid rain. So now we are going to discuss what is acid rain. So how will you define the term acid rain as? You will define it as precipitation with a pH less than 5, right? So how this pH turns acidic, right? Why the pH becomes 5? It is because this acid rain, it contains a mixture of these two acids. What are these two acids? It is sulfuric acid and nitric acid. We have H2SO4, that is sulfuric acid, and we have HNO3, that is nitric acid. How are they formed? Well, when we have sulfur oxides and the nitrogen oxides, first of all, look at the sulfur oxides. They form sulfur trioxide, and when this oxide combines with water vapor, it forms H2SO4, which is sulfuric acid. And then we have this NO, that is nitrogen oxides. When they combine with oxygen, it forms nitrogen pentoxide. And when this oxide of nitrogen combines with water, it forms another acid, that is HNO3, which is nitric acid, right? So this is sulfuric acid and this is nitric acid. So acid rain contains a mixture of these acids, and the ratio of these acids can vary, right? So what is acid rain? Precipitation with a pH less than 5. It contains mixture of these two acids in major amounts, that is sulfuric acid and HNO3. Just remember how they are formed. We have the oxides of sulfur. When it combines with water vapor in the air, it forms sulfuric acid. We have oxides of nitrogen. When they combine with water vapor in the air, they form nitric acid, HNO3. Now, as a whole, what is happening? You see that we have these two acids. When they combine with water vapor, they form acid rain. And this acid rain produces lot of effects. Now, what is the first effect? We'll be discussing increasing, it increases acidity of soil. So, when acid rain is going to fall, this is going to lead to the acidity of the soil. So, when the soil is going to be acidic, then obviously the plant life, the flora is going to suffer, right? So, it increases the acidity of the soil. Secondly, it leads to acidification of water bodies. So when this acid rain mixes with water bodies, it is going to affect the aquatic life, because many fishes, many aquatic animals, they live, and they are going to suffer because of the water bodies that are going to turn acidic because of acid rain. Then acid rain also corrodes marble. So many monuments which are made of marble, many statues made of marble, they are getting corroded because of the acid rain, right? So you must have heard about Taj Mahal in Agra. The marble is turning yellowish and it's going to get corroded. Why so? Because near Agra there are many industries because of which the rain over there which falls on the marble is quite acidic, and it is leading to the corrosion of that marble. Then acid rain destroys natural forest also. So when it falls on natural forest, it also destroys them. So these are the effects of acid rain. So just remember how you're going to define this: precipitation with a pH less than 5, and this is how these two acids which are responsible, which make the rain acidic, they are there, how they are formed. And these are the effects of acid rain, right? So I hope this very simple idea, this very simple topic is clear to you, the acid rain.